Hello, welcome back, this is Happy Growers here, and this Let's Play of Tales of Phantasia is brought to you by MuchGames.ca. In last episode, we entered Midgard. I did a stupid thing, so we were pretty much forced to go into the castle. And now something have happened here at the castle, and we shall check out what have happened exactly. And first of all, I want to adjust my chair. There we go. You got to do something! The demon has kidnapped a child! Mr. Morrison is back there with a demon! What are we going to do? How did he get in here? It's Dowse we're talking about. Mr. Morrison, what is it? Whoa.
It's about time you showed up.
Yes, Dorna, what do you want of us?
I'm here to deliver a message from Dowse himself. You were warned. You wanted a war, so let your war begin.
What do you mean?
Don't move. Take one more step and I'll disembowel him.
You wouldn't.
I can and I will. The blood of the innocent is already upon your hands. This is what Midgard wants, not me.
Archie, watch carefully.
Huh? You couldn't have.
Ah! Edward, no! This is a very preliminary form of magic induced time travel.
That will be the last spell you ever cast.
Please don't make the same mistake I did.
What's happening?
Oh, I see, he's actually time traveling. Removing Yastornia from this time. That was just like when Tornix. Edward. Well, we do know he's a Morrison because he actually sacrifices himself to save us, so. Archie, do you still have any doubts about how we need to deal with Dowse? You saw that! That coward would do anything to see us dead as long as he doesn't show up himself. Alright, I'll keep my mouth shut from now on. Class. Now that Edward is dead, has history changed? I don't know, but that's the second time Morrison saved our lives. This is too much! We need to defeat Dowse once and for all! Again, Archie did give a valid point, Class. Dowse has a very good reason for his fighting, which we'll find out eventually, I hope. I'm not sure if it's actually explained in this game or not. It's explained in an anime, at the very least. Take a look at this map. Yeah, that's Midgard. As you know, Dowse's castle is just to the northeast of our country. Yeah, it's pretty nearby. And we have to go through the Valhalla Plains first. There's only one bridge between here and Dowse's Island. So this is obviously the only viable battleground. We'll be waiting here for all the battalion to meet and join forces. We estimate that Dowse's forces will reach Midgard in 5 days. It is imperative that we intercept Dowse's army before then. If we take more than 5 days, then the enemy's troops will be able to invade the city. We got to hold our ground while a strike force takes out their commander. It's a dangerous mission, but it's the most effective way of attack. General Atwood, we will head the first team. General Marquez will lead the second group. The third group will be headed by General Faulkner. Clarth, I'd like you to lead the final group. Are you sure you want to place a man with absolutely no military training in command? You're forgetting yourself, General. I had this military, and at this moment, I got no tolerance for insubordination. If you're having any doubts, I suggest you pack up and leave now. Otherwise, sit back down and start following orders. Yes, sir. If I didn't call your name just now, please leave, as I'd like to consult with the team leaders. You'll all be informed of our strategy later. Go into town and pick up any equipment you think we may need. I got to stay here and plan. I've arranged for you to stay at the inn. Come back to see me tomorrow. Okay, so now we got a chance to go to the weapon shop. While I've already been there. Oh well. That's video game for you. Video games. All clear. You'd best be your best behavior in front of His Highness. The fate of Midgard is in our hands now. Yeah, it sure is. Anything up here? Nope, but I assume this is the royal bedroom. Very close to the surface. So yeah, let's head to the shop again to see if they have new equipment. Yeah, thank you. And no, they do not. So screw this and just head to the inn then. The thing is, actually there is nothing when I think about it. Welcome, Leeson told me all about you. You need a rest? Good night. Definitely needs the rest. Oh, look at that, the Midgard song actually stopped. And now the awesomeness of it begins yet again. So yeah, let's head back up to the castle. Is there anything else here? Nope. Only a courtyard. Now let's head back to the same room to see Clark. Clark, are you finished? Yes. We were up all night, but we're finished now. Well, what's the plan? It's obvious that the soldiers wish that they didn't need help from outsiders like us. Why should they care? Well, we just have to prove to them that they couldn't have done this without us. How's the machine? It's functioning perfectly. We'll see how Dallas feels after a taste of the Mystic Cannon. Ha! I wouldn't recommend blasting that thing, Lyson. In the year 4202, in Alvanista, the people prepare for disaster. The bloodiest war in history, the Valhalla conflict. The war's greatest hero, Edward D. Morrison. Has his death changed the outcome of the war? Who knows? Who knows? Only time will tell. And that, my friends, is the end of the game. Thank you all for watching. Of course it's not the end of the game, what do you think? The king will reward you accordingly to your performance in this battle. What? We're not mercenaries. We should be out here for the love of our country. Well, let's get this started. Good luck. The goal is to reach the general of Dallas' army and take him out. If you are touched by an enemy in the environment, you'll have to fight them. And northeast through the plains to the commander. And we're at day one. Go get him! You can rest here, but it'll take 8 hours of time away from your time. No, I don't want to rest here. The government has funded me to supply the army. You can use my stores for free. What can I get for you? Come back anytime. Well, of course I will. So, let's have a few fights then. Old Oak. That's a new enemy. Also, this event is time-based, if I recall. So, do not fight every enemy. Just fight a few, and then get your way ahead. Because the thing is here, like I said, it's time-based. We have oh, look at that, both of them gain levels. We have to get to his commander, to the commander in 5 days. And every battle will take a set amount of time. And time will change as you travel. So that's why it's important not to fight every single enemy here. But do fight a few just to gain EXP and whatnot. Also, Clarth should have plenty of magic, but he should have helping magic at the very least. Such as Luna. And Orchid's Ray should help as well. Okay, one Oak remains. Hopefully Ray shall take care of it. Or not. Then we'll end it all with a Burning Soul. Didn't really see what we got there, but that doesn't really matter. Ooh, Chimeras. They're essentially a re-skinned, or a recolored Basilisk. And hopefully Luna will do a lot of damage here. Yeah, then again I think Maxwell would have been a better choice. Let's see. An old Oak, eh? Let's use a Fury Slash, not a Furry Slash. 900 of damage. I really hate how slow Fury Slash is. If it was any faster than this, that would have been great, but it's not, so that's very unfortunate for us. There we go. All because he used Shake. So we got 700 EXP this time around. That's awesome. It's actually turning to evening. Let's head this way actually, and it's night. More old oaks. Quite a boring enemy, but hey. Also, in this area, none of the bells will be cut out, due to the fact that the music is still going throughout the fights. That was kind of pointless though, Clarth. But, oh well. Oh, Tractor Beam, we haven't seen that in a while. And again, we haven't seen Archie's low-level magic either. Archie gained a new level. Awesome. Did not meant to fight this guy. A Goomy. Please tell me it's hit the old Oak as well. Okay, good, Agumi is dead. And this should take out the old Oak and kill it. Yeah, it does. Awesome. Just follow the road, by the way, and you will eventually find the general of Thousand's army. Seems like random encounter is still in play though. And hopefully Luna will take them both out now, but I kinda doubt it. Time for a burning soul, there we go. Might as well fight this guy then. Two old oaks again. Really like how she says Ray. Sounds like she says Lay! But oh well. Uh oh. Stupid move. That was a waste of TP. Oh well, as long as I stay above 200, I should be fine, really. And as long as North and Archie stay above 200, should be fine as well. They do have a high amount of MP nowadays. TP, I mean, of course. It's midnight, rest now, sure. Of course, it's gonna take 8 hours, so don't rest every night. Yeah, we're on to day 2. Okay, one of them are dead. And Luna should take care of the rest. Okay, only 900. So time for a burning soul. And apparently a ray. Oh well. Let's continue upwards. And you know you're closer to the target when you actually change to the frosty weather. Ice needle, really? Oh well. Don't think that's the general though. Or actually it might be, and we're paralyzed. Let's see. I do believe that this spell should work here. Oh, that's a lot of damage. This spell should cure it. Okay, apparently not. Darth, you better use Maxwell on this guy. Gonna take some more damage here before using the item. There we go. So I do believe every mid general or something like that is a a Chimera's. There we go, that's Remedy Bottle. Can't believe I didn't find that. Okay, we're actually encountering more Chimeras now. Maybe I was wrong about it then. I'd say Luna would be a great asset here, yeah. Took them both out in one hit. Can't believe we got 700 HP for that, but that's pretty good. Yeah, Goom is actually immune to fire. Interesting to know. Hopefully that do damage both of them. Doesn't seem like it. Oh, it killed the one. Yeah, thanks for that, Luna. Fry me. There we go. Oh, class gained a new level and learned Air's Love. Did not meant for that to happen, but it did. Let's see, skills. Don't really use Blade Storm. Ask the goddess Air to heal you. Did not meant to do that, but sure. So yeah, now Klaas can heal himself. So let's try it out. Oh, it heals quite a lot actually. Now, it's not an attack I would recommend to use, but it works, most definitely. But keep in mind that once you have equipped a skill, you cannot unequip it until you're done with the battle and all that. So sometimes it's better to keep your skills with you. The one you actually attack with and whatnot. Look at that, Klaas gained a level as well, awesome. So it's a big plane with few enemies. Yeah, I knew he was going to attack me. It was pretty damn obvious. Yeah, I better attack normal instead. Oh yeah, I had that equipped. Tempest. Oh, look at that, a save point. Awesome. So, let's use this save. Here we go. Should I continue? Actually, we'll pause here and they will continue later on. So yeah, this has been a little... Actually, no, I shall continue with all this. I will just split up the episodes. So either it will split at the night or it will split here. Oh, we're actually at the general.
It's impressive that you made it this far. I'm Ishratu, Dowsa's general. Now you must die.
So, we have two drakes and Ishratu. I'd say it's time for us to call many spirits. And use many spells. What this means, value HP over TP. Okay, good. So yeah, the drakes shouldn't be the biggest issue here. That should be a rather small issue. See, they're already dead. So yeah, I would definitely split this episode into two parts. And it will the split will probably have been at the... when I slept for in the first day. Okay, 5000 HP in total. Not too interesting. Ishratu is almost dead after all. Yeah, just like that. Archer gained a level. And poison amulet was obtained. Look! Dowsa's army is retreating! Let's head back. So yeah, let's leave town for now. Save the game again. There we go. So anyhow, this has been Alpagrodus. Thank you for watching. Stay frog everyone, and I hope to see you next time. See you then.